Today, a Brighton pioneer producer and filmmaker, Phillip Grabsky, joins us in studio. Phil has been working on a series of art film exhibition on screen. So when the Van Gogh Museum decided to rehang the entire collection, Phil seized the opportunity to tell a different story and take a fresh look to one of the world's favorite artists, Vincent Van Gogh. But let's start from Phil. What brought you to Brighton?
When I said I was moving to Brighton, he said to me, you've joined the open toe sandal brigade. Now, of course, everyone wants to live and work in Brighton, but in 1990, it was just us and one other company. So we've been here a long time. We have made dozens and dozens of documentaries for the BBC, Channel 4, ITV, Channel 5. In 2009, I had the idea of making films about these major exhibitions, which we were doing for television, but I wanted to do it for the cinema. It's just better on the big screen. Van Gogh was unbelievably passionate and committed to being the best painter he could possibly be, which meant that he talked to every painter. He went to every gallery he could. He copied every style of painting. He learnt his craft, and then he chose deliberately to paint in that particular way. So to understand Van Gogh, you have to understand him not as somebody with mental health issues, but somebody who was passionate to be the greatest artist he could be.
I saw your documentary. I was quite impressed by the production, especially the actor you choose to interpret Van Gogh. A little bit of behind the scenes. How did you find him?
He was amazing. Jamie de Courcy is his name, and I share the directing responsibilities with my colleague David, and David directed the Van Gogh film. He saw somebody in Searchlight without a beard. I don't know what he saw, because we were looking for somebody who was a great actor but also had some physical similarities. To the actor's credit, when he came for the audition, and there were a few people that David auditioned, when he came for the audition, he had grown his beard, which has some natural kind of red to it, and he wore clothes of the period. Very clever, because when he walked in, David was like, OK.
That's him.
That's the man. The similarity is uncanny. And right at the beginning of the film, as you've seen, we do this transition from a self-portrait to our actor. He doesn't speak lines, but you just have a sense of the passion, the commitment, the difficulties, the struggle. And I think the fact that he's very good actor, but also he has this similarity, visual similarity, because we, of course, can compare to the self-portraits. You can see what Van Gogh looked like.
One of the last line of the documentary says, life is short, art is long.
Yeah.
How do you take your take on that?
I think that if you're going to invest an enormous amount of time and money and effort into anything cultural, whether it's a poem or a book or a painting, TV channel, films, you have to feel they have some value, because otherwise it's so disposable and superficial.
Well, hopefully the technology will encourage other filmmakers to produce a
Absolutely.
Great piece of art. So we kind of are running out of time. And where we can see the documentaries?
Well, in Brighton, it's on at the Comedia on the 26th of March, I think it is, and the 1st of April. I think that the evening screening on the 26th is getting close to being sold out. 1st of April is a midday screening. There's more seats there. That's where I'd encourage people to see it.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Phil.
Thank you.
For more art and news, stay tuned on Latest TV News.